applications of cold rush la, and we discussed the solubility product, how to determine solubility product from cold rush la. Now see the example. Specific conductance of AgBr at 298 Kelvin is 8.5 × 10⁻⁷ Siemens per centimeter. Lambda naught of Ag plus and lambda naught of Br minus are 62 and 78 Siemens centimeter square per mole. Find KSP of AgBr. So to calculate AgBr solubility product, see, AgBr gives rise to Ag plus plus Br minus. So solubility is S mole per liter, S mole per liter. So therefore KSP is equal to concentration of Ag plus ion into concentration of Br minus. So KSP equal to S square. Right? Now how to get solubility? Solubility is obtained from cold rush law. According to cold rush law, solubility of AgBr is equal to kappa into 1000 by lambda naught of AgBr. So it is 8.5 × 10⁻⁷ into 1000. Lambda naught of Br minus is equal to lambda naught of AgBr. So 62 + 78, which is equal to 140. So it is 140. This is solubility. Now KSP is equal to S square. 8.5 × 10⁻⁷ into 1000 by 140 square. So you will get the answer. Now we are going to the second part of very, very important part of electrochemistry, electrochemical cells. See, we discussed some important points regarding electrochemical cells in the introduction lesson. Just we recall that topic. See, electrochemical cells produces or generate electrical energy due to a spontaneous a spontaneous redox reaction. So if a redox reaction is carried out in electrochemical cell, then the cell produces electrical energy. So this is what chemical energy converts into electrical energy. I gave one example in the introductory lesson. See, a zinc rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution. So this is copper sulfate solution. A zinc rod is dipped in it. See, when zinc rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution, zinc dissolves in the solution. Zinc dissolves in the solution. And some copper is precipitated, means copper came out from the solution. Here Cu2 plus ions are present. They are precipitated. They came out from the solution. Zinc entered into the solution. Zinc dissolved means zinc entered in the solution. Copper is precipitated means copper came out from the solution. See, zinc dissolved in the solution, copper is precipitated. So therefore, you can write the equation as Zn plus CuSO4 gives rise to ZnSO4 plus Cu. It is a spontaneous reaction. So reaction occur on its own, without the help of external agency. See, Zn plus Cu2 plus ions are present in the solution. It is in solid phase, aqueous solution, solid phase. Now, SO42 minus ions are present on both the sides, no need to consider. Aqueous solution gives rise to Zn2 plus ions present in the solution, Cu solid. So zinc entered in the solution, Cu2 plus ions came out from the solution. So see, it is oxidation state. Oxidation state of zinc is 0, here 2 plus. So zinc is oxidized as Zn2 plus. 2 plus, here oxidation state of copper is 0. So Cu2 plus ion reduced as Cu. So it is a spontaneous redox reaction. And moreover, here a large amount of heat energy is evolved. This energy is chemical energy. This chemical energy converts into electrical energy. When the reaction is carried out in electrochemical cell, if zinc rod is directly in contact with copper sulfate solution, whatever be the amount of heat energy released in the reaction is absorbed by the solution only. Due to that, temperature of the solution increases. Here it is not possible to convert whatever be the energy released in the reaction into electrical energy. So therefore, the same reaction is carried out in different method. Now see, construction of electrochemical cell. Construction of electrochemical cell. Once again, remember here, zinc rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution. There is direct contact between the reactant, zinc and copper sulfate. So it is not possible for us to get electrical energy. Now, the same reaction, but we are carrying in the different method. See, construction of electrochemical cell. Construction of electrochemical cell. See, electrochemical cells are also called voltaic cells. Voltaic. Volta designed first electrochemical cell. That is why it is also called voltaic cell. Also called galvanic cells. Galvanic cells. See, nowadays we are using X-side batteries, Amaron, these batteries. Not only these, previous we used in olden days, not now. In olden days we used every day batteries, Nippo battery. Now I think these we are using in three-wheeler, two-wheeler, four-wheeler. All these are examples of electrochemical cells. Duracell, these are also electrochemical cells. All these are called now batteries. Batteries. The batteries which we use in mobiles, calculators, watches, next laptops. In all these, we are using batteries. All these batteries are examples of electrochemical cells, and these are modified electrochemical cells. Now, in olden days, we used sulfuric acid as electrolyte. Now, we are using in this generation, we are using lithium ion batteries. So what are the batteries we are using? Laptops, mobiles, they are modified form of these voltaic cells, galvanic cells. Construction of electrochemical cell. Now see, this is a beaker. So let us suppose that solution is ZnSO4 solution, concentration 1 molar. Now in this, a zinc rod is dipped in it. Zinc rod is dipped in it. A zinc rod is dipped in ZnSO4 solution. Now another beaker, copper sulfate solution. Copper sulfate solution. Let us suppose that 1 molar in which a copper rod is dipped. So, see, here there is no direct contact between zinc and copper sulfate, right? Zinc rod is dipped in zinc sulfate solution. A copper rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution. Now, if these two metallic plates are connected via a voltmeter or galvanometer or potentiometer, slowly zinc atoms which are present on the surface of zinc rod going into the solution as Zn2+, whenever these two metallic plates are connected via a voltmeter or galvanometer or potentiometer, then slowly zinc atoms will enter into the solution. Zn2+. See, this is observed fact. Now, whatever be the electrons, so that means these zinc atoms are losing 2 electrons on the surface of the zinc rod and going into the solution as Zn2+. Zinc atoms losing 2 electrons on the surface of the zinc plate, zinc rod, enter into the solution as Zn2+. Oxidation, loss of electrons. Now, these 2 electrons, this is the direction of flow of electrons. So when these electrons move to copper electrode and accumulated here, due to this, Cu2+ ions accept those electrons and enter into the surface of the copper rod. So that means Cu2+ ions gain those electrons and deposit on the surface of the copper. So, like this, zinc dissolves in the solution. At the same time, copper is precipitated, deposited on the copper cathode. Copper cathode, this is zinc anode. So, when zinc and copper are connected together, then zinc dissolves in the solution, means because zinc atoms which are present on the surface of the zinc rod loses electrons there itself and then enter into the solution as Zn2+. Then these electrons are pumped into the external circuit and they reach copper electrode, means copper rod. Their Cu2+ ions in the solution absorb those 2 electrons and deposit on the copper. So zinc dissolves in the solution and copper is precipitated. Zinc dissolves in the solution and copper is precipitated. So here the reaction is Cu2+ aqueous plus 2 electrons gives rise to Cu. So this is reduction of reaction. Now, here, after some time, flow of electrons stops from zinc to copper. Because as Zn2+ ions enter into the solution, number of moles of Zn2+ ions is greater than number of moles of SO42-. Is it clear? See, 1 molar ZnSO4 solution. Number of moles of Zn2+ ions is 1 mole per liter. Number of moles of SO42- is 1 mole per liter. So number of moles of Zn2 plus equal to number of moles of SO4 2 minus. Therefore, solution is neutral. But when zinc enters into the solution as Zn2 plus, the number of moles of Zn2 plus is greater than number of moles of SO4 2 minus. So therefore, solution acquires positive charge. Solution acquires positive charge. Similarly, CuSO4 solution, number of moles of Cu2 plus, number of moles of SO4 2 minus equal initial state. But now, number of moles of Cu2 plus is less than number of moles of SO4 2 minus. Therefore, the solution acquires negative charge. Solution acquires negative charge. Solution acquires negative charge. Whenever solutions get charges, whenever solutions acquire charges, here electrons are accumulated, therefore zinc atoms will not enter into the solution. Or in other words, solutions acquire charge, therefore flow of electrons stops. So therefore, for making the reaction as spontaneous, generally we use a salt bridge is used. Salt bridge is nothing but a U-shaped glass tube. A U-shaped glass tube like this. Two ends are open. Now, in U-shaped glass tube, a strong electrolyte like KCl, NH4Cl, KNO3, a strong electrolyte is saturated with agar-agar gel. This is a gel obtained from the plant. Okay. Agar-agar gel is saturated with this strong electrolyte, and it is filled in this. For example, here KCl is filled. Then these two ends are closed with cotton flakes. So that same salt bridge here placed in these two beakers like this. Two ends are closed with cotton flakes. Let us suppose that KCl is there. Agar-agar gel is saturated with KCl. Now, here solution acquires positive charge. Whenever solution acquires positive charge, Cl minus ions in the salt bridge will enter into the solution to make it as a neutral. Similarly, whenever solution acquires negative charge, the K plus ions will enter into the solution. Remember, salt bridge will not allow mixing of two solutions. Remember, only thing is cation will enter into the solution possessing negative charge, and anions will enter into the solution possessing positive charge. That's all. Whenever solutions become neutral, then spontaneously electron flow from zinc rod to copper rod. So flow of electrons is nothing but current. So this cell produces electrical energy. Now, what is the reaction here? Zinc solid Zn2 plus in the left hand side beaker, and in the right hand side of beaker Cu2 plus aqueous plus 2 electrons gives rise to Cu solid. Now, what is the overall reaction? Zn solid Cu2 plus aqueous gives rise to Zn2 plus aqueous Cu solid. The same reaction taken place here. Now, oxidation Hopf reaction, deelectronation, loss of electrons. Remember, oxidation Hopf reaction takes place at anode. So zinc acts as anode, and Cu2 plus ions are reduced as Cu, therefore copper acts as cathode. So at anode, oxidation Hopf reaction takes place. At cathode, reduction Hopf reaction will take place. Remember, in both electrolytic cells and electrochemical cells, in both the cells, oxidation Hopf reaction takes place at anode. Reduction Hopf reaction takes place at cathode. Remember that. But here, anode, electrons are accumulated at anode. Therefore, the rod gets negative charge. The rod gets negative charge. Here, the rod gets a positive charge. Remember, in electrochemical cell, anode is negative electrode. Anode is a negative electrode. Cathode is positive electrode. Clear? Very, very important. So what are the important differences between electrolytic cells and electrochemical cells? In electrolytic cells, electrical energy converts into chemical energy, which means that a non-spontaneous redox reaction can be carried out by utilizing electrical energy. In electrochemical cell, converts chemical energy into electrical energy. So that means electricity is produced due to a spontaneous redox reaction. Okay, electricity is generated due to spontaneous redox reaction. that is the first important difference between electrolytic cell and electrochemical cell. Electrolytic cell, a non-spontaneous redox reaction is carried out by utilizing electrical energy. Electrochemical cell, electricity is generated due to a spontaneous redox reaction. Next, second important difference is, in electrolytic cell, anode is a positive electrode, cathode is a negative electrode. In electrochemical cell, anode is a negative electrode, cathode is a positive electrode. These two are very, very important differences between electrolytic cell and electrochemical cell. And remember that whatever may be the cell, whether it is electrolytic cell or electrochemical cell, in both the cells, oxidation half reaction takes place at anode and reduction half reaction takes place at cathode. So here the same reaction can also be written as Zn solid, Cu2 plus Ir, ions are there in CuSO4 solution. So CuSO4 gives rise to Zn2 plus ions are present in with SO4 2 minus, therefore ZnSO4 and Cu solid. Both are correct only, but generally in electrochemistry, SO4 2 minus ions are spectator ions, there is no chemical change. So that is why we use it to write the equation like this only in the ionic form. Now, the efficiency capacity of electrochemical cell to produce electrical energy is expressed in the form of E0, EMF, electromotive force. E0 cell is equal to E0 cathode minus E0 anode. So, Daniell cell, it is nothing but a modified form of voltaic cell. Here, Volta used salt bridge. In Daniell cell, the salt bridge is replaced by a porous diaphragm. And you can see that Daniell cell in the NCERT textbook or any physical chemistry textbook. So, that E0 cell is equal to E0 cathode minus E0 anode. E0 cathode, what is the meaning? Cathode electrode potential value. Anode electrode potential value, E0 anode. So, the difference in electrode potentials between cathode and anode is nothing but electromotive force of the cell, EMF of the cell. E0 cell is equal to E0 cathode minus E0 anode. E0 cell means the cell is at 25 degrees Celsius, 1 atmosphere pressure, concentrations of the solutions is 1 molar. 25 degrees Celsius, 1 atmosphere pressure, and concentrations of solution in the anode compartment and the cathode compartment is 1 molar. Then cell is said to be standard cell. A standard cell is represented by E0 cell. If temperature is not 25 degrees Celsius, not 1 atmosphere or 1 molar solution, not 1 molar solution, simply it is represented by E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. And EMF of the Daniell cell is found to be 1.1 volt. EMF is expressed in volts. 1.1 volt. So that means the difference between electrode potentials of cathode and anode are 1.1 volt. If cell is at 25 degree Celsius, 1 atmosphere pressure, concentrations of the solutions in the anode and cathode compartment is 1 molar. Now, representation of a galvanic cell. Cell representation. Cell representation. See, first we have to represent, we have to write the anode. Physical state. If it is a liquid, say L. Solid, S. Gas, G. Like that. Anode. Then put an oblique. And electrolyte in the anode compartment. Anode, its physical state is mentioned. Electrolyte in the anode compartment. Concentration also we have to mention. Then separated by two vertical lines represents salt bridge. Anode in contact with the electrolyte in the anode compartment, its concentration along with the physical state. Same way, electrolyte in cathode compartment, separated by cathode, it's a physical state. Here concentration of the solution also. So this is general. Anode half cell. What is anode half cell? Anode and anode in contact with electrolyte. Which electrolyte? And what is its concentration like that? That is anode half cell. Next. Separated by two obliques, cathode half cell. Remember, in electrochemical cell, electrode and half cell, one the same. Anode half cell, electrode anode. Cathode half cell, cathode electrode. So, anode half cell, anode vertical line, electrolyte in the anode compartment. Cathode half cell, but you have to write first electrolyte and then cathode. So remember, anode and cathode are extreme left hand side and right hand side. So therefore, this is also called left hand side half cell. Cathode is present in right hand side, therefore a right hand side half cell. Otherwise, anode is LHS electrode, like this, right? Anode half cell and cathode half cells are separated by two vertical lines. Anode half cell always represented in the left hand side. Cathode half cell always we have to write in the right hand side. So that is why anode is called left hand side electrode, cathode is right hand side electrode. Right. Now, anode and cathode must be written at left, extreme left hand side and right hand side. In between, electrolytes are represented. Anode, cathode, electrolytes in both the compartments, they are separated by two vertical lines. Now, how to represent our voltaic cell? जिंक सॉलिड इट इज इन कॉन्टैक्ट विथ ZnSO4 सॉल्यूशन एनोड हाफ सेल एंड नाउ कैथोड हाफ सेल सॉल्ट ब्रिज CuSO4 सॉल्यूशन कॉपर सॉलिड concentration of the solution is 1 molar concentration of CuSO4 1 molar or can also be represented as Zn solid Zn2 plus ions Cu2 plus ions Cu solid Zn2 plus ion concentration 1 molar Cu2 plus concentration is 1 molar. Remember, any element with its own ion, element in contact with its own ion becomes electrode. Any element contact with its own ion became electrode. So remember, whenever an element is in contact with its own ion, then it acts as a half cell. It acts as electrode. Remember. Now, so like this, we represented cell. Now, see, cell is represented like this, ZnSO4 solution, CuSO4 solution, Cu solid. So, cell is represented like this. Now, what is the reaction at anode? What is the reaction at anode? See, SO42 minus ions are spectator ions. Zn solid, Zn2 plus. So that means ZnS converted into Zn2 plus aqueous. Now balance the charge with electrons. So this is how to write the reaction at anode. Next, what is the reaction at cathode? What is the reaction at cathode? CuSO4 to Cu. So SO42 minus ions are spectator ions, right? So therefore, Cu2 plus ions in the solution converted as Cu solid. Now, add electrons to balance the charge. So I added 2 electrons to balance the charge. Now, what is the net cell equation? What is the net cell equation? See, first write the reaction at anode. ZnS gives rise to Zn2 plus aqueous plus 2 electrons. Reaction at anode. OHR, oxidation of reaction. Cu2 plus 2 electrons. Cu solid. Reaction at cathode. Reduction of reaction. Most important. Whenever you are going to add both the half reactions to get net cell equation, मेक श्योर दैट की नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन बोथ द हाफ रिएक्शंस मस्ट बी सेम. इफ नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन बोथ द हाफ रिएक्शंस इज नॉट सेम, देन फर्स्ट इक्वलाइज द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन बोथ द हाफ रिएक्शन एंड देन एड बोथ द हाफ रिएक्शन. Like ion electron method. See, we balance the redox reactions by ion electron method. Like that only. Now, see. Zn solid plus Cu2 plus aqueous gives rise to Zn2 plus aqueous plus Cu solid because two electrons get cancelled. So, this is net cell equation. So here cell is given, cell representation is given, cell is represented, then they may ask questions like this. What is the reaction at anode? What is the reaction at cathode? What is the net cell equation? Similarly, if net cell equation is given, how to represent the cell? That is also important. So I am taking the same example so that you can understand easily. See, cell net cell equation is Zn solid Cu2 plus aqueous gives rise to Zn2 plus aqueous plus Cu solid. Now, to represent the galvanic cell, first identify the species which is oxidized. Zn0 2 plus, so this is oxidized. Oxidation state of zinc increases from 0 to plus 2. So, zinc is oxidized. Therefore, zinc is anode. So, therefore, copper is cathode. Then, what is anode or what is electrode? Element in contact with its own ions. So, Zn in contact with Zn2 plus ions in the solution. Salt bridge, Cu2 plus ions in the solution, Cu. So this is how cell is represented from the net cell equation. Now, for example, Ag plus Cu2 plus gives rise to Cu plus Ag plus. Ag solid, Cu2 plus aqueous, copper solid, Ag plus aqueous. So this is net cell equation. This is net cell equation, right? So how will you represent this electrochemical cell? Representation of cell. Now, first identify which is oxidized. This is Ag0, Ag+. 0 to plus 1, silver is oxidized. So, silver is oxidized to Ag+. Anode. Therefore, anode. Cu2 plus reduced as Cu, therefore cathode. So, first anode half cell, Ag, in contact with Ag plus ions, aqueous 1 molar. Next, salt bridge. Cu2 plus aqueous, 1 molar Cu solid. Now, one more example. Ag for example Zn solid Zn2 plus aqueous Ag plus aqueous Ag solid. Now, how will you write the net cell equation? Write net cell equation. Zn solid 2, Zn2 plus aqueous, Zn2, Zn2 plus. Add 2 electrons here. This is at anode. Next, Ag plus aqueous. 2 Ag. So here add 1 electron. This is reaction at cathode. See here number of electrons in both the Hopf reactions are not same. To equalize this, multiply this equation with 2. Add Zn solid 2 Ag plus gives rise to Zn2 plus aqueous plus 2 Ag. This is net cell equation.